Hi guys, this is Harpreet again. I'm a registered nurse in BC, Canada, and a nursing coach as well. First of all, a huge thank you to each one of you for appreciating and liking my last video about NNAS application process. If you like my work and want to see more of me, please subscribe to the channel to keep yourself updated about the upcoming videos. Well, today we're going to talk about English. Now, why is English such an important issue with internationally educated nurses? Because we come from countries where English is not our first language, it's not our mother tongue. And when we move to Canada, English kind of connects us because Canada is a multicultural country and English is the most spoken language all over the country because that's kind of a common language, right? And as nurses, it's very important for us to be able to understand our patients about what they need, and communication and language plays a very important or a huge role in that. That is the major reason why we have to prove ourselves proficient in the language spoken by most Canadians. That is English proficiency again. Now, to prove ourselves proficient, we have to go through some standardized testings, and we have two options to follow along. So your options are IELTS and Salbin. Now, if you have ever dreamt of coming to Canada or you're already here, you know what IELTS is. It's a globally famous exam for English, right? So I'm really not going to dig into details about what the test is because I'm sure you guys know. But a very important thing which I want to mention is that for NNAS application, we need academic IELTS, which should not be older than 6 months. Then, talking about CELBEN. Now, CELBEN stands for Canadian English Language Benchmark Assessment for Nurses. So this is a test specifically designed thinking about what nurses need to do with their patients, how they need to talk. So in CELBEN, we talk about nursing. That's simple, right? And now I want to mention about the required scores for both these tests. But before that, I want to let you know that both the tests are almost similar because both of them have listening, reading, writing and speaking components. So it's almost kind of parallel testing, similar types of tests, right? Now, the required scores or the minimum required scores which you need to be able to fulfill your application process are, for IELTS, you need an overall score in academic IELTS, overall score of 7. You need to have 7.5 in your listening. In reading, you need to score 6.5, and in speaking and writing components, you need to have 7 each band scores when it comes to academic IELTS. For CELBEN, the scores are compared on Canadian language benchmark, so there are no overall scores, but from each component, you need to have scores of like 10 CLB when it comes to listening. In your reading and speaking, you can have 8 CLB level each. And for writing, you need to score a minimum of 7 CLB level. So these are the scores for both these tests, the minimum required scores. And remember, these tests, they should not be older than 6 months when you have to apply for NNAS. So there are two ways people usually do it. The first way is we will start our NNAS process and within 1 year, we will try to finish or get our English proficiency. That's fair enough. And the second way is I want to first complete my English proficiency and then apply it to NNAS. So make sure you apply as soon as you get your results because you don't want to cause any unnecessary delays and further complicating your applications, right? And another very important piece of advice which I want to give to you all personally who are in the process, who have to get their English scores done, or who are thinking of starting their process, or who just are little budding aspirant nurses or nursing students who want to come to Canada. Make sure, guys, invest in English. Get that solid foundation because I've personally seen a lot of people struggling to get their English scores met, and you really don't want that your English scores are actually holding you from going ahead in your application process. It's very painful to see that. So work on your English, invest some of your time and money if you have plans to move to Canada. That's kind of a very important thing you need to think about, right? So yeah, if you have any questions, any queries, you can always let us know in the comments. You can contact me through your Facebook. And I also want to mention that English is not the test of anyone's intelligence. It's just a language. But when it comes to nursing, language is very important because communication is an integral part of our practice. So please work on that. And I wish all of you good luck on getting your scores met in your first attempt. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So keep watching. Goodbye.